Guys, this is the stage in the morning where people order me to order you around.
Oh, it is?
Yes, it is. That's why I said it was. I don't do it this way when it's my class. I just start, but... Great, so I'm only waiting for people to find comfortable and pleasant places to sit next to people they like or space they need. Columbia Law School spends vast amounts of time, money, and effort repairing power ports. So if you're sitting next to a non-functional power port, please raise tuition and, you know. But there ought to be infrastructure for everybody. We are joined by a tiny number of invisible people, probably at this stage of the morning only in Russia. Our friends in California have many things to do before they join us, unless, like Eileen, they have come to us by way of Tokyo and are chipper and bright and ready to go. And actually, this time of the morning, even in California, I can find Eileen without any difficulty, but that doesn't mean she's watching streaming of silly events like this. Okay, so good morning and thanks for coming. This is approximately what I am accustomed to a room around here looking like at 9:30 in the morning, which is why I try never to teach before 11. But nonetheless, because of how far I know people have traveled and how thoughtful I know they have been about what they were going to do when they got here, it's great fun for me to see you all right now, right here. I said a year ago at the end of this, okay, see you in 10 years. And I meant it at the time. I seriously meant it at the time. And then two things happened, one of which was I looked in the mirror and I saw that gray hair and I thought, maybe that was some risk of overpromising and under-delivering due to phenomena beyond our control. And the way we practice law is to try to avoid things like that. So on the theory that see you in 10 years was not the sort of performance guarantee that we like to make. This is also why we told our clients some years ago that we don't do their trademark 10-year work. Pay attention to that, please. We'll send you a reminder, but we won't guarantee to do it ourselves. I realized that I had given a 10-year service commitment, and that was a bad idea. So the way to cheat the service commitment was to turn it into an annual meeting. And I just want you to understand that the real reason you're here is to participate in my risk management. Lest I die before the next decennial meeting, you are going to be invited frequently to come here in the meantime. If you force me to go through blood pressure testing or whatever in return for this, I will reluctantly submit. We are in good heart this morning. We have a lot of interesting things to do because a lot of smart people have traveled a long way across many time zones to come here and talk about the stuff that only we like. And we do have a lot of stuff to talk about that only we like, one piece of which is GPL compliance that we'll get to in a moment. In addition to how much we like talking about compliance enforcement, we also like talking about free software projects, trademark licensing policies, a wonderful, very interesting and exciting subject we almost never talk about. But as usual, at least in my experience, when you expose the actual clients to the lawyers for the companies who use the stuff downstream, it's always a wonderfully engaging and fascinatingly educational experience. My clients will say it's really educational, but it only works in the other direction. They learn less, but it isn't true. Everybody learns by watching how extraordinarily interesting this community is that combines the people who make vastly valuable capital equipment just because they want to. And the people who really know how to turn that vastly valuable capital equipment into the global economy. Over the time I've been doing this work, over the last almost quarter of a century, this is year 22 since Richard Stallman first said, you have a possibility of being able to solve a problem for me, would you like to, which is Richard's usual way of doing it. Over those nearly 25, now just 22, but counting, I'm hoping to get to the 10th anniversary, I have watched as this happened, a bunch of people who made wonderful software just because they wanted to are now part of why there's $500 billion in a year in the global economy made out of free software doing this and that in mobile phones and clouds and suitcases and blenders and dishwashers near you. And that ability to operate harmoniously in a world of deeply cutthroat competition, in which there has also been a multi-tens of billions of dollars patent war going on and a whole lot of other usual hot metal flying around because capitalism, that a bunch of people are able to cooperate, make stuff, have fun making stuff, give it away because they like making stuff for other people to share, and it all works and it isn't destroyed by the deeply important competitive ethos of modern industrial activity, is a wonderful little miracle, like the bumblebee that can't fly and the extraordinary stuff that the microbiome does that could only be done by exoplanetary life and so on. And what we do when we talk about the little details of this is we scrutinize this mechanism of wonderful life. And it's nice to think that there might actually be a lot of stuff to do every single year around here talking about that. If my students got up this early in the morning, they could learn right from now about some quite amazing things that law school will otherwise never afford you the opportunity to learn. So thanks all for coming, and maybe my students are watching the stream while they work off last night's bar review or whatever it was they were up to. We can hope. Right now, we have the physical challenge of having a conversation about GPL enforcement, dispute resolution, and cooperation, and facilitated communication. I look at this arrangement of chairs, which we have been talking about for days on 68th Street, and I realize that we did two things. We assembled a lot of really important people to talk about this really important subject, and we arranged for them to sit knee to knee and agree about everything. So please do. Mishy, my legal director, law partner, and guiding good judgment about things like this has made all this work. I turn it over to you. If you can get these people to agree about even one thing this morning, we can have world peace. Come on up, guys, and let's get started.